this video I start to build my new homemade table saw using a circular saw. And I don't use this, but I need this for cutting doors or big sheets of plywood. So I buy a new one, the same again. Here we are, the two sisters, or brothers, I don't know. Why Bosch? Because I want to have quality for my new homemade table saw. There are two ways to use a circular saw for a homemade table saw. One way, it's the easy way. You take a plywood and you mount the saw on it. Like so. But the problem is, here is not a lot of meat, and there is a bit of play in there. But this is the easy way, and another way is the right way, and I use the right way to do this. The first step is to get this all apart, because I just need the motor and the blade. I do this off camera because if Bosch show my video, I don't want Bosch cry. So that's all what I need. I save all the pieces in the case I have to bring this back together, or I need a new piece for my other circular saw. So now I can start to build my new homemade table saw. I have no plan for the table saw, just an idea. Instead of this, I will make a very strong frame for the motor. And for the pivot point, I have this bolt. For the tilt. I just work my way up. So the first thing what I'm gonna do is to transfer these holes to this board. And after this, all the holes for the other boards. I mark the top of the boards to make sure I don't change any direction. Fits quite nice, but this is in the way. The question is, I cut it or I don't need this. I think I cut it. So let's have a look. Yeah, it's better. Oh, earthquake, sorry. Now here's a button for if you want to change the blade for block the for block the turning. What I do here? I cut. This piece was mounted with this little screws. For the plywood, it's not long enough. So I just mark how long the screw go in the housing. And I replace this with my, and what I have this screws. They are the same diameter as the original. So now I just cut a bit of the tip, and here I have good screws. The alignment for the pivot holes for the bolt, very critical. You have to be very, very careful and use a very, very sharp pencil. Again, a very, very sharp pencil. Again, a very, very sharp pencil. Take your time to mark the holes so exact as you can. It looks good. It looks good. So let's check the alignment of the blade. It's 1.8. The first board is finished and in place, and the alignment it's correct, saw blade and the first blade. And now I have to make all the other pieces, and I cut out this just with my bent saw. I just finished the four layers for the motor. The first layer is mounted on the motor. You have to look. The alignment is correct on all sides with the saw blade. And I use four layers. 1, 2, 3, 4. For I have enough strongness. And I think these four layers, it's strong enough for a motor mount for the tilt. And next step is I glue and screw this together. And if you do this, you have to look the alignment with the pivot point have also be correct. So here you can see the first layer. If you build a table saw like me with a circular saw, you have to look and make some adjustments on your saw. Here's the motor mount, all glue and screw together, and I let this dry overnight. And tomorrow I start to build the tilt lift and also the trunnions for the miter. One hour it's enough. I think I can cut off some parts. Not so bad, not so bad. So, the first part is finished. See you in the next part.